wanted to take a look at basic functionality around comments. So comments on your site allow other users or readers to basically talk to you about the content that you're creating on your site. There's a section within My Home on that left sidebar that you can jump to. And so there's functionality built in you can enable and manage, and then you're also going to have kind of ability to moderate, because the internet's a crazy place. Sometimes people just comment anywhere they can with links trying to drive traffic to different places. They'll comment with things that are totally irrelevant. So we have some spam protection built in for that, which is nice, and you don't have to worry too much about that. But that means that you also need to kind of go in here and check on what comments are there and which are valid, so you can approve them and respond to them and all that good stuff. So let's go into, actually, let's first go into settings and let's check out, there's a discussion section in here that'll give you some options. So I'm going to click on discussion again. And so this is going to give you a lot of the options to enable comments and control how they work on there. So notify any blogs that you link from your articles. So it'll send somebody else, if you put a link to somebody else's content, it'll let them know that you link to them. That's a great way to get them to share your content to their audience, and a great way to help build your following. Link notifications from other blogs, meaning if other people are linking to your content, you can get a notification about it and do the same thing. That's a great way to build a community with other content creators and not just your readers. That'll help all of you kind of build a symbiotic community of readers that maybe are overlapping in topics that you cover, even though they're slightly different. They kind of are interested in both, or multiple kind of places where they might overlap. And then you can, of course, allow people to post comments on your new content. You can let visitors use a .com, Twitter, Facebook, or Google account to comment. I should probably actually have that enabled. It's fine with me. And then there's all these other settings you can require. So the comment author needs to fill out their name and email. That helps prevent some of the spam. They must be registered and logged into your site to comment. I don't have that one enabled because I don't think they should have to create a whole account just to enjoy the content and engage with it. You can close out comments that you haven't responded to or approved after a certain amount of time. So there's a bunch of settings in here to kind of control that commenting experience. We don't need to go through all of them one by one. What I really wanted to make sure is you knew that those are there. And then we can jump over to the actual comments section of the site. And this is just where you're going to see essentially all the comments which are pending and need approval, which have been approved. So if I had gone through and said, yeah, this is fine, it would be live, that's fine. Which were caught as spam and marked as spam, and then which ones you kind of deleted or threw away already. So you get a full history to manage all of that in there. And if you're actually publishing content on your site, which I haven't been, and you're actively engaging and sharing your site, you'll get a lot more of this happening. Sometimes it happens through the reader. If you go to WordPress.com/read, you can see a bunch of our other kind of customer sites and content as it comes through, and even subscribe to them there and comment from there. Sometimes it just happens as people find your site and your content as you share it across social media, or if they find it on a search engine. So people can come from anywhere and discover it, comment it, and start a discussion. It's a great way to kind of engage and build loyalty with your audience and connect with the people on the other side of it.